He wasn't only a fellow photographer, he was our brother. We loved him a lot. He was just one of those special people that you could not help but not love and respect. He was the epitome of a cool cat. He was my guy. I loved him.
I'll never forget the day he got this dog that kind of came out of nowhere into his life and became his child, and he was always trying to convince me that it was okay to take sick days because his dog was sick. No matter what you asked Mpozi to do, he was always like jumping at it. If you asked him to wear a bulletproof vest and ride around in the most dangerous neighborhood, he would do it, but if you sent him out to do a restaurant review, he was fine doing that too.
The vibe that he left in this newsroom every day. He was just the sweetest soul, and he just gave so much of himself to us, and we didn't even realize it every day that he was giving us a little piece of himself.
I've known him from his early days in Philadelphia, when he and Clarence Williams, two young cats who had great passion and vision and desire to express themselves and to document the worlds that they knew that were neglected in mainstream media. I still feel his spirit and miss him dearly.
To go into any room with anybody here in Indiana and completely disarm who was there. And at first people, you know, he's 6 foot six and he's got these big dreadlocks. I mean, we all know about that, but just his personality, and he had to be like that, very giving and warm and caring and sincere and generous. And that's really what I remember about him. He's my brother, and he was all of our brothers here in Indianapolis, and we'll miss him.